Welcome to my Discrete Mathematics course. In this video, I'm going to give you an introduction of the topics that we are going to discuss on this series. So the first topic is the foundations. So the foundations of discrete mathematics are logic and proofs. Why we say that those are the foundations is because the rules of logic specify the meaning of mathematical statements. So in mathematics, most of the things are about statements, and we are going to give meaning to those statements using the rules of logic. Logic is the basis of all mathematical reasoning and of all automated reasoning. It is usually applied in different areas of computer science, such as the design of computing machines, specification of systems, artificial intelligence, among others. So, what makes up a correct mathematical argument? In mathematics, an argument must be correct. And usually, after one state an argument, anyone can prove that argument is right or is wrong. It is not the type of arguments that we usually have in our day-to-day life. In mathematics, every time you want to state something, you need to create the proof. You need to make a formal proof. No one will believe in something just because you are saying it. So there is a movie that is called The Man Who Knew Infinity. It is a very interesting movie. It's based on a true story. I suggest you that you watch this movie so you understand how things work in mathematics. And once you say something or you solve an exercise, you need to understand that you have to create proofs. Even if you don't create the proof, all the steps must be easily proved. Once we prove a mathematical statement is true, we call that a theorem. And a collection of theorems on a topic organize what we know about the topic. This means you can create your own theorems, and once you prove them, then everyone will recognize those theorems. And you can also create a theory around any topic that you want. You just need to do it in the right way. When you learn a new topic in mathematics, you need to actively construct arguments. So that's why understanding what is an argument and how to prove it is so important. That's why it's called the foundations. And when we study logic, we start on that topic. So knowing the proof of a theorem, it also gives you the ability to modify the results to fit in new situations. Let's say you need to apply the theorem to a new area of knowledge. That new area of knowledge might have another conditions. So if you understand how the original theorem was proved, it will be easier for you to modify the theorem to adapt it to the new situation. Proofs are very important in mathematics, but many people find it surprising how important proofs are in computer science. In computer science, proofs are used to verify computer programs to show that an algorithm always produces the correct results, among others. The more you study computer science, the more topic you study, the more you realize how important is proofs and mathematics in general in computer science. So we will see in this video series several topics about discrete mathematics. The basic structures from discrete mathematics has many applications in computer science. That's why we are going to study them in this video series. Say, for instance, sets can be applied in programming, data structures, databases, formal languages, and compilers. Functions are applied in programming, sequences are applied in programming and in creating proofs, and so on. So every topic that we are going to study in this video series will have an important application in computer science. Therefore, if you are studying computer science, these topics are very important for you. Another topic we are going to study in this series is induction. It's a powerful method to create proofs, especially useful in computer science. You will see many examples during these videos on how induction is used to create proofs of algorithm correctness. We are also going to study counting. Counting is another important topic. It is used in algorithm complexity. We need to count how many operations an algorithm have to execute in order to get the result. It is also used in cryptography, in experiments, in programming. So it has many applications in computer science. Another topic we are going to study is relations. Relations are extremely useful in databases. It is actually the foundations of databases. It is also applied in programming and in data structures. We are going to see examples of each one on the specific video of relations. Then we are going to study graphs. Graphs are applied in computer science, in data structures, in modeling, and in networking. Then we are going to study trees. Trees is also applying data structures in modeling and in operating systems. So as a summary, in this video series, we are going to see the specific topics of logic and proofs, basic structures, induction, counting, relations, graphs, and trees. Thank you very much. See you on the next video.